Hello everyone, you all are welcome here. Today, I am going to discuss a most important topic, that is electrostatic. What is electrostatic? Electro means charge and static means rest. So we are going to study the behavior of force between charges when charges are kept in vacuum with a separation of some distance. Let us understand this topic with the help of an activity. So here we have taken some piece of paper and we are rubbing a pen over a sheet of paper. So during this rubbing, due to friction, a charge is developed over this pen. And when we brought this pen over the charge pieces of paper, then this paper will get attracted toward this charged body. So there is a force of attraction between this charged body and paper. So we can say there is a force exist between these two objects, and that force is attractive here. So one scientist, its name Coulomb, suggested that there is a force of attraction or repulsion between two charged body. So you see here, while rubbing, we get this body as charged, and this charged body attract the other piece of paper, other body, which represent that there is a force of attraction between the charges. So Coulomb, a scientist, explained that when two charges are kept at some distance, there is a force of attraction exist. So here there are two charges. When they are kept each other, there is a force of attraction, and the force of attraction or repulsion is given by a law. That law is called Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law states that the force between two charges is directly proportional to the product of their magnitude and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Here you see, this is the formula for force. Force is equal to K, magnitude of charge Q1, this is charge Q2. Both will either attract or repel. Attraction and repulsion explain the meaning of force. So F is electrostatic force, K is Coulomb's constant, Q1, Q2 are the point charges, and R is the distance. So according to Coulomb's law, write down, according to Coulomb's law, if there are two charges, that is Q1 charge and Q2 charges, they are separated by a distance R, and if these charges are positive, then these charges will repel each other. So there is a force of repulsion. So that force of repulsion is given by, force is directly proportional to the product of magnitude of charges, and force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So it indicates that if charges are more, then force between them is more. If distance is less, then force also, if distance is less, then force is more. Force of attraction or repulsion between them is more. Here these charges are positive, that's why here there is a force of repulsion. If these charges are opposite charges, then there is a force of attraction. So if we combine these two equations, we will get a third equation, that is F is proportional to magnitude of charges. So if we remove this proportionality sign, we get a constant. That constant is called electrostatic constant. The value of K is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught R. So epsilon naught represent permeability of free space. This is permeability of free space, and epsilon naught R is the relative permeability. So for vacuum, the value of ER is 1. So in short, we can write force formula according to Coulomb's law 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 upon r square. Because the value of er is how much? Er value is for air, it is 1. So Coulomb's law is valid in air or vacuum. We can apply in any medium also, but the law is given, the law is derived in air or vacuum. And if we solve this value, we will get a constant value, that is 9 into 10 to the power 9, that is q1 q2 upon r square. Okay, r is the distance between the charges, q1 and q2 are the magnitude of charges. The value of epsilon naught is a constant value, that is 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 11. This is also a constant value. Let us solve one numericals related to this Coulomb's law. Suppose we have two charges, that is q1 charges is 2 microcoulomb, q2 charges is 3 microcoulomb. They are separated by a distance of 1 meter. Find the force between them. We have to find the force between them. This is positive charge, suppose this is negative charge. How to find the force between them? As you know, these are two charges and these are opposite charges. One is positive and another is negative. So there is a force of attraction between them. So that force we can calculate by just putting these values, that is k, q1, modulus. This line represents modulus. We have to take positive values, q2 upon r square. So the value of k we know. So what is the value of q1? That is 2 microcoulomb. 1 microcoulomb is equal to 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb. Coulomb is the unit of charge. Coulomb represents the unit of charge. So q1 is 2 into 10 to the power minus 6. q2 is 3 into 10 to the power minus 6. And r is 1. So if we solve, we will get k value is 9 into 10 to the power 9. 2 into 3 is 6. And 6 plus 6 is 12, but here it is minus 12. So finally we get the attractive force between them is F is equal to, that is 9 into 6 is 54 into 10 to the power minus 12 plus 6 plus 9, it gives 10 to the power minus 3. So this amount of force is the answer. This is the amount of force acting between these two charges. Micro represent 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb charges. So the basic properties of this Coulomb's law, both charges will experience a force. This will also experience a force. This will also experience a force. This will experience attractive force when these charges are opposite in nature. Opposite pole. Like pole repel each other, unlike pole attract each other. So both will experience a same amount of force and they obey the Newton's third law. So always remember, Coulomb's law is valid for point charges. Coulomb's law is valid for when we kept the two charges in air or any vacuum. We can also apply Coulomb's law when we kept the charges in any medium. For any medium, we have to just put the value of dielectric constant. Okay. So in medium, write down, in any medium, Coulomb's law is given by k q1, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught r. This is q1, modulus of q1 and modulus of q2. So if we put the values of this is represented by a capital letter k, that is electric constant. Er we can write small k. Here this is small k, this is capital K. It is also called relative permeability. For water, its value is 81. For air, its value is 1. Here we have to write q1 and q2. So in general, we can write F, Coulomb's law, Coulomb force in any medium is given by Coulomb's law, Coulomb's law in vacuum upon divided by dielectric constant. So this is all about electrostatic force. Electrostatic force is a short range force, but it is more powerful, more stronger force compared to gravitational force. And Coulomb's law obey for point charges only. And it is valid for vacuum and we can apply in medium also. And Coulomb's law is inverse, it follow inverse square law. This is all about Coulomb's law. Thank you.